please meet Jubia. I met Jubia 1.5 years ago during a training program that I was delivering in a university. She came on stage, she needed to present a business. So she came on stage, she started telling about her experience of growing chicken at the backyard of her house. Very few chicken, and the reason for that was that her production costs were too high, so she couldn't manage to save enough to make the business grow. The reason for that was that the cost of feeding was too high, and so at the end of the cycle, she could just keep doing what she was doing, make something at the end of the month. Jubia is one of 11 million people in the country that are unemployed. But even more concerning, Jubia is one of 700,000 young Mozambicans that every single year come out of university with a piece of paper in their hand, one more line in their CV saying, I got a degree, and no idea whatsoever what to do with their life, besides dropping that CV in a few public institutions. If they know somebody because their family has a bit of connection, they might manage to get some job. Otherwise, they're left, like Jubia, doing some informal jobs to make it at the end of the month. It so happened that I had a solution for Jubia. We started farming insects to actually produce feed for her chicken at a much lower cost. We started a business together, and that made Jubia what we may call an agropreneur. What is an agropreneur, you may ask? So to me, an agropreneur is a definition of a person who is doing business, so he's an entrepreneur, an innovator, that acts along the food value chain. That is, acts on everything that happens to take food from the field to your plate. So from farm to fork. Because at the end of the day, most of humankind still produces food that way, right? We take it from the field and we put it in our plate. So you see, agriculture in this continent is one of the most spread way of producing income for most of the families. In Mozambique, though, despite 80% of workforce working in agriculture, it represents only 26% of our GDP. And the most concerning part of that is that of that 80% of people that work in agriculture, most of them are women. But most of them do that just out of survival. They grow just enough to feed themselves, to feed their family, and that's it. And this is a big challenge. It's a challenge that has been seized. A lot of aid money has gone into it. A lot of movement have been created, programs have been created, initiatives, reports have been written. And at the end of it, the problem is still there. Right? Just this year, Dr. Alesina, who is the president of the African Development Bank, declared there is no reason whatsoever that Africa is a net importer of food. So what is the problem, really, with agriculture? Specialists would tell you that the problem lays in the nature of the business, in the fact that agriculture is a business of very low margin, is a capital-intensive business, it's very risky, the lower the level of technologies that you adopt. It's the kind of business that we may call a dirty business. The business that doesn't work unless you get your hands dirty. And it's the kind of business that doesn't give you weekends, holidays. Because your chicken are there, they need to eat every day. Your field is there, you need to water it every day. So what is really the problem? You see, I work in the entrepreneurship ecosystem. And for us, we have a say, which we are very often hearing, which is, if you have an opportunity to invest in a business, you back the jockey, you don't bet on the horse. What does that mean? It means that when an investment opportunity comes, the first and most important factor for you to decide where to put your money is not the nature of the business, but is the people that are behind that, is the entrepreneur behind it. So what's the story? What's the problem with agriculture? To me, the problem is the kind of stories we tell, because that determines the kind of people we attract. into agriculture and into doing business in agriculture. So you remember Jubia, right? You saw her in a picture at one of the, probably the biggest event in the country for young people on stage, sharing her story. Quite of a fancy thing, actually. But when I met her, we were at a training focused on innovation and biotechnology. That's something cool. However, try and Google agriculture, African farmer, African agriculture, African food production. Let me tell you what you get. You are very likely to get a picture like this. This picture, or any other picture you're very likely to get, is a picture of a woman carrying a child at her back, bending over to the ground, collecting a few leaves, planting a few seeds. Definitely not the kind of aspirational status any one of us here would like to have, nor the kind of status any other young person in the country would like to have. So what's the problem? The problem is that agriculture is not sexy. Agriculture in the continent is woman, but it's not sexy. Now let me tell you what is sexy. Business is sexy. Profitable business, even sexier. Profitable business with a purpose, with an impact on society, that's G-spot. Yeah? So let's make agriculture sexy. What if, now follow me, what if we could create a platform, and in this platform we gather all the actors and all the stakeholders that have an interest in food security, nutrition, rural development, agriculture, right? What if we can bring together, sitting at the same table, NGOs, foundations, banks, corporate sector, private sector, government, public sector. We make everybody speaking the same language. Everybody that have resources, knowledge, technical skills to be put into agriculture for the continent, speak the same language, align those resources, and align strategies. And then what do? We bring to that table SMEs. Small companies that have so much to offer along the value chain of all these big entities. What if those small businesses are not just randomly called? We go around the country and we select the best, the most promising, those that already have a success story to tell. And we bring them on board and we help them to grow their business. We give them access to funds, access to markets, access to clients, access to new opportunities, and we help them better structure their business. And when we have done that, what if we go into universities? And now we bring all those stories of agripreneurs, successful business people, to share their stories with the young people that, being seated in university, are very likely to become the elite of this country. Are those ones that are privileged enough to have access quality tertiary education. And we inspire them. And because of the stories they're hearing of successful agro-entrepreneurs, they're going to start thinking that they can be famous if they want, they can be rich if they work hard enough, and they can do all of this by being agropreneurs. And they can actually create jobs and feed their country, or contribute to feed their country. Now, what if we give a name to this whole thing, and we call it the Future Agro Challenge? Yeah, that's cool. I thought so. So for the past 3 years, with my company and a few other very enlightened organizations, we've been doing exactly that. We have gone around the country, trained thousands of youths. We have scouted hundreds of businesses, selected a few of them, and provided to them business development services for them to get better access to markets, better structure their business, access funding, and being able to actually grow and build those kind of stories that we so desperately need to change the story of agriculture in this continent, to change the story of food security in this continent. But this story is just in the making. This Future Agro Challenge initiative has already been spread in other African countries, but there is so much more that can be done. So many actors, so many institutions, so many players that can still come on board, so many young people that are yet to be inspired by those kind of stories and decide that they want to actually contribute to feeding their continent. And there is so much that we can still do to make sure that Africa becomes a net exporter of food and definitely a food secure continent. Aren't you concerned with what you put on the plate of your children, on your own plate, on what your community is fed, your country, the world? I am. And I thought of three solutions for that. So you, yourself, could be an agropreneur. You could invest in agribusinesses if you have the resources to do that. And if not, you could simply support agropreneurs with any kind of service that a business needs to grow. As of me, I am making agriculture sexy. And you? What are you doing to feed the world? Thank you.